is all about pop culture meets entertainment. And as we always say, we have something for every fan, and every fan is a fan of something. And so whether it's Star Wars, Marvel, or Disney, or it's anime, or it's sports, or it's music, or it's Rick and Morty, Game of Thrones, it's Flintstones, it's Scooby-Doo, we have something for you. And with whimsical products and amazing interactive shopping. And we took 40,000 square feet on Hollywood Boulevard, and we created an environment that no one's ever seen before with retail shopping. And it is absolutely retail meets entertainment. And it is amazing. When people go in, they're gonna be blown away. Well, our whole company's success is based off that really tight-knit relationship we have with the Netflix, with the Star Wars, with the Marvels, with the Disneys, with the Warner Brothers and the Potters. And so, you know, we had a vision. They saw our flagship store up in Everett on a smaller scale, and they were so supportive of what we were trying to build. And just trying to find a way to show our love of their brands to our fans in an interactive way, and they support us every way, every step of the way. So,
I think people inherently like to collect things. I don't know what that says about the human experience, but I think that that's something that humans like to do. Personally, I have hundreds of these at home. So to answer your question, why? I don't know if I can. All I can say is that I do, and I've committed to it for a reason that's bigger than you or me. They're adorable. They're the cutest thing.
I don't collect anything. I just found out about Funko like a couple weeks ago, and I was really excited like to just look at all of the dolls, and I was really excited that they were going to have, you know, us-themed characters. So I'm just really excited to see what they look like.
Oh God, I have been buying Funko for a long time. I don't know where I first found out about it, to be honest, but I've been a collector for as long as I can remember.
What's your prize Funko statue?
My Miss Piggy.
Really?
Yeah. She's not very expensive, but a lot of people don't make Miss Piggy stuff. So when you find it, you gotta hop on it.
Well, an ex-boyfriend of mine actually had a custom Dina Funko Pop made for me, and so that is my prize statue, which is, it is, yeah, it's displayed very prominently in my home, which is one of the few things I've been given by an ex that I still display in my home.
I just started collecting them, like, not too long, like, last year. And I haven't really had the time to buy them all.
So what attracted you to them? Because, again, it's like there's so many different things out here, but why?
Because they're small, and they have these, like, big circle black eyes. And they're like, they have big heads.
Okay.
And they just look cool to me. I don't know why.
If Funko Pop called you and said they want to make an action statue of you.
What?
Yeah, I know. Would you do it?
That, first of all, that would be weird. Second of all, yeah, sure, maybe. Yeah, depends on what it looks like. Because if they don't get my nose right, then it has a problem.
They have a problem, so they have to get your nose right.
Nothing gets my nose right.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Jeremy McGuire, and you just got buzzed.